I was very happy with my plastic blender until...
I mean, doesn't this concern you?
Senator, it does concern us.
Well, how much does it concern you? Enough that you all you do is just rely on what a study that comes from the industry itself? You should go to their website today and read what they say about phthalates, completely contrary to what is out there in scientific journals. It's a disgrace. And it obviously doesn't concern you enough to do something about it.
To start to do what we're supposed to do, not what the industry always asks us to do. You have any response? None. Think everything's okay?
Hi, I'm Lina Muma. In this video, I'm going to explain why I bought an old Vitamix model. It's a stainless steel 2200 model, which was introduced in 1969, when I already had the modern Vitamix model 5200. And in the next few video, I will compare those two blenders side by side with common recipe task. I will be making nut butter, nut milk, green smoothie, and salad dressing. As you can see, the 5200 model mostly made with plastic, and 2200 model made with mostly stainless steel and metal chrome base. Vitamix no longer make 2200 models, but you can buy used ones on eBay for only $100. Or if it's very good condition, maybe you pay $150. But I cannot guarantee you that. Or maybe after this video, price get even higher. This model has 64 ounces pitcher, about 8 cups. And this one has 48 ounce pitcher, which is about 6 cups. 5200 come with a plastic plunger. This model usually sold without plunger, but my husband made me nice plunger from backyard tree. Vitamix 2200 can easily fit under the counter. But Vitamix 5200 is much taller. And as you can see, it cannot fit under the counter. To fit under the counter, we need to take top off, and then it's be able to fit under the counter. But you have to keep top somewhere nearby. I bought my Vitamix 5200 about 4 years ago. I bought it to make it more raw food for my family, and especially for my son. After a year, I was making smoothie, and I left spoon inside, and look what happened. Smoothie just went through, and smoothie was everywhere. Unbelievable mess. So I had to call Vitamix to buy a new pitcher, and I asked, how often people left a spoon inside? And person who I speak with told me that almost every day somebody called because they left a spoon inside. Now I know I'm a fool with a lots of company. To replace just a plastic pitcher without top and without the blade, it will cost about $65. And Vitamix do not take broken containers to recycle. And my Kerry recycle do not accept number 7 plastic. You can see the recycled number on the bottom of the pitcher. Vitamix customer support actually recommended me to throw broken pitcher into the garbage. I holding until I will hopefully will take to recycle center, which accept number 7 plastic. Apparently, Vitamix recycle all stainless steel blenders, and they actually offer $100 towards the purchase of a new plastic unrecyclable blenders. That's right. Destroying the old one instead of repairing and replacing with non-recyclable, non-biodegradable plastic blender. What location on our planet do you think is better for non-biodegradable throwaway plastic garbage? On the land, so we can see reality? In the land, so we can hide reality?
Although most new sites have a layer of clay spread beneath the liner, which both act as a barrier to stop chemicals leaching into the groundwater, it seems this method is flawed, and that all barriers will ultimately fail, making dumps a potential threat for hundreds of years.
Or in the water, so we can pretend to hide our toxic lifestyle reality. I was very happy with my plastic blender until I watched the documentary Plastic Planet. I start to rethink my plastic habits and I touch the plastic pitcher inside around the blade. Listen, it's all rough. It's not smooth anymore like here. Can you hear? And I realized that I'm adding plastic into my family diet. So I decided to buy stainless steel, and I found that you can find on eBay perfectly working high-speed blender and low cost. Eventually I end up buying two of them because Vitamix do not make parts for this blender, and I like to have two pitchers. Once again, all rough inside, not smooth. I'm eating this plastic.
I'm telling you, I'm also eating plastic. Styrofoam seems like real food, since it always has a little flavoring from the real food left on it. Sometimes it's so good, it's to die for. We are in the park where I can dine on the fan plastic. It is good for your health, no? The plastic is good for you. Maybe I share with you. Would you like to try?
I've been researching plastic and often finding deceptive messages from plastic manufacturers.
After a decade of research on low-dose exposure to BPA, Dr. Frederick Lumsall's findings captured the media's attention. His work, corroborated by other independent scientists, led the Senate to investigate the FDA.
The media has reported that the federal government's reluctance to regulate these chemicals is based on the reliance of biased studies from the chemical industry itself. Now, I have to tell you, if that's true, doesn't that cast amazing doubt on the ability of the regulatory system to actually protect the public?
Senator, at FDA, all of our products that we approve are based on data that are prepared and conducted in studies by that particular manufacturer.
All you do is just rely on what a study that comes from the industry itself? It's a disgrace.
They didn't get it right with Vioxx. They're not getting it right with bisphenol A. And there's going to be hell to pay over this.
Senator, we have looked at all the studies in the literature, and there are hundreds.
The Food and Drug Administration did not look at all the evidence. They looked at two studies produced by the chemical industry and made their decision on that basis.
Have you asked for studies from independent sources?
We don't normally ask for independence.
Then you don't protect the American people.
The National Institutes of Health reviewed 700 peer-reviewed published studies on bisphenol A. 38 internationally recognized scientists said, we are extremely concerned about the impact of this on human health.
It happens over and over again that regulatory agencies are captured by the industries they regulate. And certainly the Food and Drug Administration, especially the food branch, is one that has really been in the food industry and the packaging industry's pocket for many years.
Tritan is the brand name plastic made by Eastman, used in Vitamix, Blendtec, and many other products, and is claimed to be both BPA-free and EA-free. So I emailed Vitamix in January 2013 with my concerns about plastic being chipped into my food from the inside of the Vitamix container. My experience has been that companies do not always tell the public the truth or the full truth, so I requested the Vitamix provide me with independent scientific studies. In other words, not studies paid by the manufacturer, showing that the blender container is both BPA-free and EA-free. I also wanted to see if the tests were conducted under normal Vitamix conditions. For a Vitamix container, normal condition would mean physical stress conditions, high-speed blending, hard objects like dates, frozen fruits, nuts, and ice being smashed against the plastic walls at extremely high speeds. The only testing I could find for this type of plastic was done in hot temperature conditions, for example in microwave or in a dishwasher at 70 degrees Celsius, which is about 160 Fahrenheit. I would hardly consider those two temperature tests to be equal to the real-world physical stresses of hard food smashing against the plastic walls at speeds of up to 37,000 RPM, equal to 300 miles per hour.
And these are crescent-shaped hard ice cubes right out of a home freezer.
Vitamix replied to my email. I have forwarded your email for review and response. I'm still waiting for a response. Is it too much for me to ask for a real-world Vitamix study? Is it too much for me to ask for studies that are independent, as in scientists or labs that are not paid off or influenced by the manufacturer? While I was waiting, Spanish and German scientists were busy doing an independent study and on March 13, 2013, reported in the scientific peer-reviewed journal Food Chemistry that when they tested new Tritan plastic water containers, they found chemical migration, meaning chemicals moving from the plastic to the water, of five chemicals, including bisphenol A, known as BPA, and benzylbutyl phthalate, known as BBP. The study was on non-moving water, which is much milder than very high-speed blending, with hard objects hitting a hard plastic surface. Let's watch what scientists think and say about BPA and phthalates.
Bisphenol A is the building block molecule that plastic that is hard and clear. Bisphenol A may be one of the most potent toxic chemicals known to man.
BPA is found in many products, including sports bottles, baby bottles, and water coolers.
The problem is bisphenol A acts at very low doses as an estrogen.
The recent controversy over BPA started when members of the scientific community questioned the methodology of earlier studies.
All regulatory agencies around the world are based on a concept from the 16th century. That is, the dose makes the poison. More is worse. That is not true for any hormone. We tested a dose 25,000 times lower than what anybody had ever tested, and we found that it profoundly damaged every single part of the male developing mouse reproductive system. There is virtually no major human health trend over the past 30 years that hasn't increased, such as childhood diabetes, that is not related to exposure to this chemical. We find it relating to obesity, breast cancer, to prostate cancer, diabetes, brain disorders such as attention deficit, hyperactivity disorder, liver disease, ovarian disease, disease of the uterus, low sperm count in men. We're talking about $7 billion a year industry. They will spend any amount of that $7 billion necessary in advertising to the American public, trying to convince them this chemical is completely safe.
Phthalates can cause a dysfunction, particularly in the fetus, and can cause adverse reproductive outcomes for males and females.
Remember to subscribe so you can be notified of part 2 and part 3 of this video. I will be making side-by-side comparison of those two blenders, making nut butter, nut milk, green smoothie, and salad dressing. Thank you.
We're going to start to do what we're supposed to do, not what the industry always asks us to do. You have any response? None. Think everything's okay?